Hello people, welcome to the channel. So in this video we are going to discuss the application of rectifiers. The rectifiers are basically AC to DC converter. So whenever we need DC supply to run any appliances, to run any chips, to run any circuit, to run any other device, we need rectifiers. Because if you see the supply that we are getting at our home, that is 230 volt single phase and 415 volt three phase. So we need to convert the AC supply into the DC supply, and that's where the rectifier will come into the picture. So I'll just give you a few names which requires DC supply. Suppose if you are running any appliances, let's say a microwave oven, so in which we are having a microcontroller that runs on a plus 5 volt DC supply. Similarly, any other appliances that has microcontroller chip installed in it, it will require 5 volt DC supply. So in order to run these applications, we need AC to DC converter, and that's where rectifier comes into the picture. Another application of rectifier is in the wind energy system. So if you see, the wind generators generates the variable AC supply, and that variable AC supply first gets converted into the DC. Then that variable DC will get converted into the fixed DC, and after that we will get the conversion from fixed DC to fixed AC. So that's where rectifier will come into the picture. Another brand new application of the rectifier is in the HVDC transmission. See, if you see, HVDC transmission has a lot more advantages compared to the AC transmission. We know that our generation is basically done by the AC generators, that is alternators. So we have AC generation and we want to transmit that AC power on a HVDC line. That means high voltage DC line. So our generation is AC and we want high voltage DC transmission. So that is where rectifier will come into the picture. Rectifier will convert the AC generation into the DC, and after that we step up the DC voltage and do the HVDC transmission. So that is another application of rectifier. In most of the cases, we will be using the rectifiers into the appliances only. Now from outside, we don't know that where is the rectifier, but inside there will be a rectifier, because if you see, most of the smart appliances will be having a microcontroller installed in it, and that microcontroller will run on plus 5 volt DC supply or maybe plus 12 volt DC supply. So it requires that small amount of DC supply. So and if you see, all the appliances are basically connected to the AC supply. So inside that appliances, we will be having a rectifier along with the transformer. Because if you see, suppose if we are using the single phase supply, so in the single phase supply we are getting 230 volt AC, but we require only 12 volt or 5 volt DC supply. So that's where a transformer will come into the picture. Transformer first step down the 230 volt into around 12 volt, and then we will be using a rectifier to convert the 12 volt into the 5 volt or 12 volt. These are some of the applications of the rectifiers. In the coming days, I'll be come up with the brand new series of the rectifiers, in which we will be seeing that what is rectifier, how the power circuit of the rectifier is there, how we can control the rectifier, how we can get the desired amount of the DC voltage at the output of the rectifiers, and what are the other concerns involved with the rectifiers. So if you have not subscribed the channel, I highly recommend you to subscribe the channel in order to get the further updates. And thank you very much guys for supporting the channel. We'll see you in the next video.